हेलो
गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? होप यू आर ऑल फाइन एंड एंजॉइंग द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। आई होप दिस इज़ द लास्ट क्लास इन द ऑनलाइन। नेक्स्ट वी विल मीट यू इन द ऑफलाइन क्लासेस। सो माई सेल्फ गुलशन शरीफ वेलकम्स यू टू महिला समाज ऑनलाइन डिजिटल क्लासेस। सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, टॉपिक 40 फॉर्चून्स, क्लास 4th स्टैंडर्ड। 40 fortunes, it's a beautiful story based on a beautiful husband and wife story, and 40 thieves who are involved in the theft and how they will accept their mistake. Let's see in this story. So what are the characters in this play? Means narrator Ahmed Jamel, minister wife, king servant, chief, and 40 thieves. So scene 1, narrator. Once in the royal city of Isfahan, there lived a young man named Ahmed, who had a wife named Jamil. He knew no special craft or trade, but he had a shovel and a pick. He was a content man, for he often told his wife, "Ahmed, cheerfully, if you can dig a hole, you can always earn enough to stay alive." Narrator. But Ahmed's wife Jamil was very ambitious. One day she told to Ahmed, "Jamil, I want you to sit in the marketplace and be a diviner from tomorrow, or I will go back to my father's house." So there was a village called royal city called Isfahan, who in that city a young man lived, Ahmed, and his wife is named Jamil. They both lived happily, but they belongs to poor family, as Ahmed was having a shovel and a pick. So shovel and a pick is the instrument used to cut the carve wood. That is a large heavy tool that has a curved metal bar with a short ends fixed at the center at a wooden handle. So it is used to break the rocks or hard ground. Okay. He used to do his hard work and try to have the small amount so that he can lead his life. But his wife Jamil is very ambitious lady. She don't want to lead a poor life. She want to become very rich and want to live a comfortable life. So once she told her husband that, "You please be a diviner." Diviner is connected with the God. So what will happen in the future, that he has to tell. That person is said to be called as a diviner. So she suggests her husband to become a diviner, or else I will go back to my father's house. I can't lead this life, horrible or miserable life. I will go back to my father's house, she told. So he is the poor person, Isfahan, Ahmed or Hussein. She is the Jamil or Shamiana. So Shamina, in this episode he has mentioned as Shamina. So in the scene 2, what happened? Let's see. Scene 2, Ahmed did as his wife said, although he didn't want to. He sold his shovel and his pick and bought the dice, the board and the robe of a fortune teller. As soon as he settled in the marketplace, the wife of one of the king's ministers ran up to him. "Minister's wife, diviner, you must help me. I wore my most precious ring to the bath today, and now it's missing. Please tell me where it is." So as soon as he can't send his wife back to his father's house, so he sold his shovel and his pick, and he bought the money, and he got some money. From that amount, he bought a dice. So dice in which he used to tell the fortune of the people. So he bought the robe. Robe means the dress what a fortune teller wears. he used to he purchased the rope from the marketplace and he sat in the marketplace. So as soon as he sat in the marketplace, the wife of one of the minister ran up to him. So when she came there, the sense means she wore the precious ring and she forgotten to pick again when she was taking bath, and now it that was missing. So she came to the fortune teller. He has to tell her that where it was. So the narrator gulped. That means he was not having any idea about that ring, though he has to tell. So as he desperately searched for something wise to say, he happened to see a bit of her naked arm through a hole in her cloak. So out of respect, Ahmed leaned and forward and whispered urgently. So he didn't get any idea what to tell. So that lady was wearing a dress in that her naked arm through a hole in her cloak. So cloak means a long gown type. In that a small hole was there. So without respecting, he leaned forward and whispered urgently. ಅಂದರೆ ಅವ್ರ ಕಿವಿ ಹತ್ರ ಬಂದು ಕಿವಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪಿಸು ಮಾತನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ. ವಾಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ದಟ್? ಮೇಡಮ್, ಐ ಸಿ ಎ ಹೋಲ್. ಸೊ ದ ಅಹ್ಮದ್ ಟೆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಈ ಸಿ ಎ ಹೋಲ್. ಸೊ ದ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ವೈಫ್, ಅಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಎ ಹೋಲ್, ಶಿ ಶೌಟೆಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ಶಿ ರಶ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದ ಬಾತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಲ್ ವೇರ್ ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಹಿಡನ್ ಹರ್ ರಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೇಫ್ ಕೀಪಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗಾಟನ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಶಿ ಕೇಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ಅಹ್ಮದ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗೇವ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಎ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್. ಸೊ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಸೂನ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಚೂನ್ ಟೆಲ್ಲರ್ ವಿಸ್ಪರ್ಡ್ ಎ ಹೋಲ್ ಟು ದ minister's wife, she imagined that she had kept the ring in the hole, not in the bathroom. She went away and she collected the ring from her bathroom and she came back to the fortune teller to give the gold coin. So the narrator, that evening when Jamel saw the coin and heard the story, she said, "You see, there is nothing to it. Being a diviner is a piece of cake." So nothing important to be a diviner, no qualification required, no special thing required to be a diviner, just talent is important. It's like a piece of cake. So so easy that just as like we eat the cake, it's so simple to be a diviner, just we have to follow the simple tricks. So Ahmed again tell God was merciful on this day. See, he bought the dice. And Hussein gulped and cast the dice in front of the minister's wife. And he said, a small hole. See, a small hole. I see a hole. Hole, hole, shouted. And she went back. So God was merciful on this day, but I dare not test him on another day. So as it was the first day and he does not want to cheat the other people, so he begged the God and God showed the path to him, right path to him, so that today he got a good reward from the minister's wife. But every day can't be the good day for us. Nonsense, if you want to keep your wife, you will be back in the marketplace tomorrow. So again she shouted like anything and ordered his husband that again tomorrow you should be in the marketplace as a diviner or else I will go for my mother's house. Ahmed signs in resignation. Andre, patient willingness to accept a difficult or unpleasant situation. Andre, he was not interested even though he has to do that job. He was in that situation. All right, I will give it a shot just for you. So again he agreed for that. Why? Because he don't want to lose his wife. See, Ahmed amazed when she gave him a coin, gold coin. So that is Jamel or Shamina, both are same here, the name has been changed. So she told that there is nothing to be the diviner, just the few tricks you have to follow. So now on that every night at the palace of the king, the royal treasury was robbed. 40 pairs of hands carried away 40 chests of gold and jewels. The king sent for Ahmed, the fortune teller, to find out the treasure. Ahmed realized that he was now in a trouble. He would neither be able to find the thieves nor disclose his true identity before the king. He had to think quickly. Thankfully, he knew about 40 chests being stolen away. So On the next day, what happened? In the next immediately the night, 40 thieves had stolen the 40 chests of gold and jewelries from the palace. So now the king came to know about the Ahmed, and the king called the Ahmed to find out who are the 40 thieves who have stolen the 40 chests of gold and jewels. So now Ahmed realized his mistake. He thought that now he is in very big trouble. So Ahmed, your majesty, I can tell you there were 40 thieves. So how he came to know that there were 40 thieves? As he came to know that there were 40 chests, the thieves have stolen 40 chests of gold and jewels, he boldly tell that there were 40 thieves. King, amazing! None of my own diviners knew as much, but now you must find the thieves and the treasure. So when he told that there are 40 thieves, the king was amazed, and now he wanted, at any cost, he wanted to find the 40 chests and the thieves from the help of the Ahmed. Narrator, Ahmed felt faint. Faint in the sense means talak tirugibidutho avanige hegappa anta anisibidutte. Ahmed, I will do my best, your majesty, but it will take 40 days. Your majesty, one day for each thief. King, a long time indeed. Very well, you shall have it. If you succeed, I will make you rich. If you don't, you will rot in the prison with the others. So anyhow, with the guards, he accepted the challenge given by the king. The king told that if you succeed in this challenge, I will make you rich. If not, you will be thrown in the prison. He is going to join with the others in the prison. Ahmed gasped softly. Soft means honestly, going to anukuntane, oh nani mattu satte anta anukuntane. See, next morning the king was reported that 40 chests of gold and jewels were stolen by the 40 thieves. So that was happened in the night of the palace. So 40 pairs of hands carried away 40 golds and jewels. See, the robbers carrying out the 40 chests. So the ministries are asking the people to call the royal fortune teller for his assistance. So scene 4. Narrator back home, that is Ahmed, he back home. Ahmed took 40 dried dates and placed them in a jar. Ahmed, I will eat one of these dates each evening. That will tell me when my 40 days are done. So narrator, now it happened that one of the king's own servants was one of the 40 thieves. And he had heard the king speak with Ahmed. That same evening, he hurried to the thieves' meeting place and reported to their chief. Servant, there is a diviner who says he will find the treasure and thieves in 40 days. So what happened in the scene 4 means Ahmed came back to home. He can't count the days, number of days, and he has taken 40 days time. So now he put the 40 dried dates, kharjura togontane. So he will put it in the jar, 40 dates in one jar. So one day after the other, he took one dried dates and put it in the other jar. So while they are speaking in the palace, one of the palace people, that is one of the assistant of the king, was the main thief of that 40 thieves. So he went to report to the thief, head of the thief. So what happened? The servant, he ran away and he informed to the chief of the thieves that they have stolen the 40 thieves. The diviner is going to express the thing. Chief, he's bluffing, but we can't afford to take chances. Go to his house. See, Hussein took some dried dates, put it in the jar by counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He counted till 40, put it in the jar. So, as soon as the servant report to the head of the thief that the diviner is going to inform about the theft, The chief told that just he is bluffing, no one can tell. He is bluffing andre reel bidta idane. Anyhow, we can't afford to take the chances. Avanu nija heltidane, sulu heltidane, yaru gottu. So adike navu chance tagolod beda. Go to his house and find out what you can see ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಆ ಡಿವೈನರ್ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗು, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತಿದೆ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಾ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ ನರೇಟರ್. ಸೊ ದ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ಲೈಂಬ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು ದ ಟೆರೆಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಫ್ಲ್ಯಾಟ್ ರೂಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅಹ್ಮದ್ಸ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈ ಲಿಸನ್ ಡೌನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಲೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಸೊ ಗಂಡ ಹೆಂಡತಿ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಮಧ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಆನ್ ದ ಟಾಪ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೂಫ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನರೇಟರ್ಸ್ ಹೌಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಥೀಫ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೀಸ್ ಲೇ ಡೌನ್ ದೇರ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಅಹ್ಮದ್ ಟುಕ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಜಾರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಏಟ್ ಇಟ್. So what he did, he put, he put the 40 dates in one jar and immediately next day he started eating it, so that if he complete the 40 dates, that means he had completed the 40 days. Okay, so the immediately next day he took one of the dried date and he had the date and he ate that one. He told his wife Shamina that that's the one. So the servant gasps loudly and nearly falls over. He was shocked that without seeing him, how can he tell that he is the one? The thief hurried back to the chief. So he hurried back to the chief and said, this diviner was having amazing power. Without seeing me, he knew I was on the roof. I clearly heard him saying that he is one. So now the chief, you must have imagined it. Tomorrow night two of you will go. So he told it, no, it's not possible. How can he say one not two? Tomorrow you two of you go and just see what will happen. So the next night the servant and a thief returned to Ahmed's roof when Ahmed ate a second date and said. So one day over means one date he ate, second date and he told that that's two. So that's one, that's two, that's three was the counting of the Ahmed here, but the thief had got misunderstand about these numbers and they realized their mistake. The thieves nearly tumbled over each other as they fled the roof and reported this to the chief. So the second day also they both went and informed the chief that now he boldly told two without seeing us. Narrator. So that night after that she sent three of the thieves. So still now he can't believe that the Ahmed was very powerful and is having magical powers and he can easily identify the thief. He said, tomorrow you go three. So the next night the three of the thieves and the next night four, then five. So it went on till the 40th night when the chief went himself. At the last night he said, no, I can't believe. So I myself will come to there. Narrator, so all 40 thieves climb up to the Ahmed's roof while Ahmed gazed at the last date in the jar, then sadly took it out and ate it. Ahmed's, that's 40, the number is complete. Now all the 40 members were there on the roof and now he ate all the 40 dates. He compared that to the thieves. He told that now it's 40, the number is complete. Narrator, just then came a loud banging at the door. See, they realized their mistake. At once, the 40 thieves. Just then came a loud banging at the door. Ahmed, the king's man already. Narrator, he knew he could hide no more. So he went to the door and unbolted it, calling. So he thought that as soon as the bell rang, he thought that the king has sent his men to call him. But now he got misunderstand. Ahmed, all right, I know why you are here. Narrator, he swung the door open. To his astonishment, he saw 40 men kneeling before him and touching their heads to the ground again and again. So all the 40 thieves were standing next to the door. They realized their mistake that the diviner has identified him as the 40 thieves, so that they rang the bell and they went inside and they bowed their heads to the ground. The chief, of course you know, O great diviner, nothing can be hidden from you, but we beg you not to give us away. So the chief of the thief will tell that, the diviner, you are just great, you have the amazing power and magical power for with you, so that you can identify us and nothing has been hidden from us. We will give you everything, but please don't tell, inform about this to the king. They beg in front of the Ahmed. The narrator Ahmed realized that these must be the thieves. He thought first and said, so suddenly he realized that they may be the 40 thieves who had stolen the chest of the palace. So he realized, very well, I won't turn you in, but you must replace every bit of the treasure. So the Ahmed told him that no, I never tell you about you for the king, but just remember, you have to replace the every bit of the treasure that you have taken from the palace at once. Yes, the chief of the thief agree. Yes, of course, at once we will replace everything. Narrator, early the next morning, Ahmed appeared before the king. So after the 40 days, the next day, Ahmed appeared in the court in front of the king. See, he appeared in the front of the court. Your Majesty, my magic arts can find either the treasurer or the thieves, but not both. Which do you choose? So he used his trick in front of the king and he went and said that, my dear Majesty, I can't find both the thieves or the treasure at a time. So just choose anyone what I can place in front of you. The treasure, I suppose. Though it's a pity not to get the thieves, the boiling oil is all ready for them. So the king said that, so at any cost, I want both the 40 thieves and the 40 chests of gold, but you are demanding me to select one, so I will go with the treasure. So anyhow, the boiling oil is ready for them to punish. Well, never mind, leave that one. Tell me where the treasure is and I will send my men right away. So here, the king asked the diviner, just tell me the address where the thieves kept the chest of the gold and jewels. I will send my person and collect back my treasure. So Ahmed tells, no need, your Majesty. Ahmed waved his hand in air and said, so just he pretend to be a big magician or diviner. He blows something in the air and he pretend his hands. Pish posh, ish ush, mish mush. By my magic, the chest have returned to their place. So he uttered few words, that is the pish posh, wish wish, mish mush, like these words. And after opening his eyes, he said the king that the 40 chests have been replaced in your palace in their particular place. So the narrator, the king himself went with Ahmed to the treasury and found it. So he declared Ahmed his royal diviner. So he can't believe the diviner. So with the diviner and with his assistants, he went to the palace, that is, he went to the place where the chests were kept, and he was shocked to see the 40 chest of gold and jewels. Ahmed bowing, thank you, your Majesty, but I am afraid that's impossible. Finding and restoring your treasure was so difficult, it used up all my powers. I shall never be a diviner again. So the king asked him to be the royal diviner and to be in his palace. He realized his mistake, that God has helped him once, and this is the second time that God has helped him, but not every time God will help him. So he told that, my dear king, in search of your 40 thieves and 40 chests of gold and jewels, I have lost all my powers. Now I can no more be a diviner, he told in front of the king. So king, what a loss. Then I must doubly reward you. Here, take two of these chests of your own. So instead of God, the king had taught him to be appointed as a royal diviner. He can't be the royal diviner as he don't have the magical powers. He played with his tricks and become the diviner. Now he can't play no more with the people. He told that he lost all his power. By hearing this, the king had the pity on him and he rewarded with the two chests of gold and jewels. Narrator, so Ahmed returned home to the Shamina, safe, rich, and a good deal wiser, and as any diviner could have foretold, they lived happily ever after. So now within this, he earned more than enough, and they don't want to have more. They don't want to need more lies with the people, and they lived a very happy, safe, rich, and comfortable life. And they could have foretold they lived very happily ever after. See, 40 days, Your Majesty, one day for each thief, he told. And they both were discussing about the thief. This was the previous one. And a long time indeed, he asked the, he was taking the permission to give 40 days time. I forgive, but the fault is mine all at the last. They are rectifying the mistake. He went to the door and unbolted it when the thieves were on the door. He must imagine it. So the chief of the thief was telling that the next day everything will be there in the right place. A loud banging at the door. That was only by the God grace he had helped find out the 40 thieves. So, glossary, perking, becoming more cheerful or lively, diviner, connected with the God, craft, all the skills needed for a particular activity, resignation, patient willingness to accept a difficult or unpleasant situation that you cannot change, home assignment, students please read the lesson and fill in the blanks. Jamil wanted him to be a dash, one who tells fortunes. There are 40 hands carrying 40 dash. Ahmed was happy to earn a little by digging holes with his shovel and pick. He was dash. So dear children, this is the last lesson of this academic year. Hope we'll meet offline class soon. Till then, take care. Stay home. Take care. Thank you. Thank you so much for your cooperation.